Welcome to my Atari ST Nostalgia Trip, and I want to have a go at another really early game this time, so I will take a look back at McCadden Bumper from 1986. And I will admit, I've always liked pinball games as a kid and even as an adult. I mean, up to a few years ago, I even owned one for some years, which was an Addams Family pinball original from Williams, which I had at home and played a lot during the weekends. So yeah, I am sort of into the mechanical pinball feel. And so this game had some special appeal to me when I was a child. And of course, it wasn't just a pinball game. It was also a pinball construction kit that allows you to create your very own tables. So yeah, my memories of the game are actually a bit vague. So I have no idea if it actually was good, if it will be good, and if I will like it. So I guess I'm going to have it to go in sort of blind and to see how much I like it. And this is one of those very early games where you had to really start it from the Jam desktop, open it from your floppy drive and start loading the game. And yeah, we have a very nice opening screen. And you see the game is created by Rémy Herbulot, who also later went on to make Kraft & Xunk on the CPC, the Amstrad CPC, and ported to the Atari ST, or Get Dexter, which is known by. Which is a game that's very much on my to-do list. And actually, the guy playing the pinball with like this sort of hairdo also has an appearance in that game, Kraft & Xunk or Get Dexter. And of course, a few years later, the same Rémy Herbulot did a game on the PC platform called Dune, which was also kind of a thing. So he was apparently a pretty good game designer. But we have this language selector where we can choose between English or American English, which I never understood. And then it sort of opens the game play field, and at the moment it's completely empty, which is a bit surprising because I thought we were here to play pinball, and the reason it's empty, it should start a demo mode actually in any moment. Here we go. It started a demo mode. It required me to play a game first. But it will clear the table, and basically it will show you a demo on how to construct the default table in the game that I loaded and played to start this demo mode, because it gives you an idea of how advanced the construction kit actually is, because you can see you can put some drop targets, you can put some sort of gates, you can put your flippers. And of course, you can put, yeah, this is like a sink or like a ball, a hole. And I think it's kind of cool. It sort of builds the table, but shows you what options you have in the game. And yeah, you can use all these construction items, which are in these default colors, but you can actually completely change the color palette for the table. You can really, really change the table. Exactly like you like it. Yeah, and of course it's putting some more drop targets there, and now it's going to create some extra obstacles, or actually remove some obstacles in this case, and then it says, oh, that one I didn't want to remove, but you can see that it's now creating some extra obstacles, so it's creating an extra lane for the ball. So if it gets into that that outer lane, it actually, you get 500 points and it goes back to your plunger, which is kind of cool, I guess. And also kind of cool is that this table in particular, it doesn't have any outer lanes that make you lose the ball, but there is quite some room between your flippers. And nice as it may look, just a heads up, the physics in this game are really not that great, and I'm really putting it very, very politely in this case. Well, it is kind of cool to show that, yeah, okay, you can create your own table, and you can sort of put objects on the table, move them to different places. You can fiddle around with the scoring within the game, like how much you score. And of course, it's going to, in this case, put it back to defaults. But yeah, this is basically to show you all the options you have, like tilt sensitivity, elasticity, the slope of the table. You can have a sort of stroboscope effect, which you really don't want. And then, of course, you can add some extra scoring, like, for instance, these drop targets. If you put down all eight of those that you just selected, It will give you an extra score, and it will give you a bonus, etc. So you can put special combinations in your table to make the gameplay rules a bit more complex. And those are all things I really, really like, that it had that complexity in it. This is 1986. It's just the problem is that, you can draw a lot of stuff. Now it's just showing that you can draw some decoration inside. And of course, decoration means you draw a bunch of stuff. You can make some artwork on your playfield, but your ball is not blocked item. It will just go over it. Well, it's not doing anything with it. So it's basically most of the stuff it shows, and it just cancels out. And it puts the controls back onto mouse. And it will even play a game for you. So it will put some coins in the arcade. It will actually select a player and then start playing a game. And surprisingly, the computer is actually better at this game than I am. According to my test runs anyway. But yeah, it's playing the game it created itself, which is, I guess, it's sort of cool. I'm not sure. But as you can already see, the way the ball moves is not very realistic. The physics are... I mean, at some point the ball bounces around like it's made of rubber. And before you know it, it's just dropping down as if the table is completely vertical and the ball is made of lead or some other heavy metal. Which will become very clear when I start playing the game. Because the computer knows how to really react to the ball in advance. Which I could probably do if I would take some time to really, really practice the game. After not playing it for, I guess, almost 35 years. This is one of those early games I played a lot in the really beginning in 1986, but after 1987 started, I don't think I played it a lot. Because there were so many other games that were much better than this one. Despite how much I love pinball. But yeah, the computer did actually quite good on one ball. But we're not going to do that, so I'm going to press a key and now I am in control. And of course the coin that the computer put in the slot is still available to me. So let's play the default table and then let's play some other tables. And the default control is actually with the mouse buttons. So you press both of them to activate the plunger. And then left and right mouse button do... What? And I don't... The computer seems to get lucky and I just seem to get very unlucky. And I remember there being some other pinball game on the Atari, where if you move the flippers just like an awful lot, the game would struggle so much that it would slow down immensely and you would actually see much better what was going on. But not... Yeah. And with this game that doesn't work, that tactic, so... I'm pretty bad at... Oh, come on, what? How did I lose that ball so early? I don't think the mouse control also is very... I mean... Yeah. You can move the mouse to actually... nudge the table. But with an emulator with a USB mouse, apparently... The signal is a little bit too strong, so I am going to change the controls, which is here. And I'm going to change them to keyboard. And I am first going to... Change the hit. What? I can't because, okay. I have to change these first and then I can change these to right shift and left shift and then right and left. Because I'm not going to hit the table anyways, but I like to have, I like to have the shift keys for my flippers. And I'm also going to load a different table. Because I think this was the table that the game came with by default. And I'm not sure if the Micmac, I think that was also one of the tables you could load by default, but I'm not entirely sure. And you can see the table looks quite different. It only has one hole where the ball can escape between the two flippers on the right side. And the other ones are protected by a bumper, unless you, of course, raise the flippers. And it has a different background, and I don't... Maybe someone else made it. I'm not entirely sure. Put another coin in. And let's see how good I went. I know I will suck. Because the physics in this game are absolutely horrific. How was I supposed to react to that? The ball went just straight into the hole and in a speed that's just impossible to react to. What? Oh. Yeah, one of the things I say in pinball, don't flip if you don't have to. Which is a tactic I wasn't complying to right there. Yeah, and here you can just have the bumper do this work. So basically, to make this table easier, I could just add a bumper in between the other flippers. But as you can see, I hit the flipper when I don't know, it reacts so slowly. The controls are so sluggish that the game is just virtually unplayable. And I probably suffered from this when I was a child also, which is probably why I didn't play it any time after 1986. So it is very easy for me to appreciate this game for what it is, but it's very hard for me to like this game. I think that's the most I think that's the best way to summarize. Oh, for God's sake! I'm even doubting. I don't think I should play another game. This is just one of those games where I should accept that it really didn't age well. It didn't age well. I mean, it's nice that it's a construction kit and all the things we take for granted now just are not there. I mean, there's no physics, no sense of real play. There's no connection with the actual pinball tables that were in the amusement halls at the time. I mean, I know that stuff like the Addams Family and Jurassic Park, that kind of tables, they were not there yet. But still, still, I would love to see something that is more similar to the tables that were around at the time. And this is just completely different, which also makes most of the tables really unplayable, because basically the programmers didn't really know how to design pinball tables, which is a profession on its own. And it makes me sort of a bit sad, because I realized simulating a table at the time was just a bit too much to expect in those days anyway. And I guess for my pinball pleasure, I just have to visit some of the great retro locations that still maintain the proper pinball experience and appreciate this piece of retro gaming for what it is. It's really a sort of relic of its time. And it wasn't very good. Even if the construction kit part is actually pretty well done, the physics are just so bad that whatever you construct in this game, you are just never going to enjoy it. I mean, not in these days anyways, and probably also not in back in the day anyways, because I also don't remember playing this game a lot. It's just a very good idea which is in the end pretty poorly executed, and that really makes me sad, because I really wanted to like this game, and sad to say, I really don't. And yeah, with that sad thought, I think it's time to end the video. I want to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Thank you.